small fish and big fish. First of all, I am not totally conversant with how to define the small fish and the big fish, whether it is by amount of crime, the gravity of crime, whether it is by the person who has done something, because I might be a big fish, me I'm small, I'm a small fish, but I might be a big fish, then I do something. I might be a big fish and I do something small, some small crime. You might be a small fish and do a huge crime. So I think fish can change, can change in between them. But let me talk about the big fish that I think popularly is known. It will generally refer to big people, isn't it? It will generally refer to big people doing big things, big bad things. If you look at our track record, I think big fish have not been above the law. And they won't be. I think my own reading of our journey since 1994, those of you who have been serving, those of you who joined later, I think that our journey has time and time again told Rwanda very clearly that it doesn't matter the size of fish you are. If you have committed an offense, if you have violated the law, if you have done something that is offensive to the law, you will be held to account. It seems to have been a message that keeps reminding Rwandans all the time that it doesn't matter the size of fish you are, you will always be held accountable. If you violate the law, there is evidence you violated the law, you will be held to account. Now, if you do embezzlement, if you do bank fraud, if you do tax fraud, if you do all these negotiable instruments fraud or misuse, as long as it is an offense in the penal code, who you are will generally not protect you. You can get away with absence of evidence, but in presence of evidence, I think you can't get away with it. Now, there might be, for every big fish, there might be a number of many small fish, meaning that there might be more people committing small offenses, and I've listened to some debates once in a while in the media and other places, talking about motorcyclists, talking about the small shopkeeper, talking about people who do who appear more regularly doing a lot of work. Those ones, because they are appearing like that in a big form. When they commit offenses, naturally they become many. But that is simply because they are that many. If you are talking about motorcyclists, you are talking about men. You are talking about civil servants. There are so many. If you are talking about big numbers of people, they are many. So statistically, you can get more of them being exposed to breaking the law and being held accountable. But those big people, what is clear, what we are reminded by our own laws and our leadership, what we are reminded all the time is that, one, you should hold yourself accountable. Two, if you fail to do that, this law that we have will hold you accountable. And it has generally happened. So with fraud, with mass embezzlement, big embezzlement with tax, with negotiable instruments, checks, and so on. There are no-go areas. These are no-go areas. You don't need to cross those lines. This country is developing at its pace. Rwandans are happy that this country is developing at this pace. But at the back of this, there is all of us and there is all these resources that we put together. So we are struggling to protect resources which need to take Rwandans from one place to another place. That is the struggle. So it's not about holding people accountable for the sake of holding them accountable. Of course, it is wrong to break the law, you will be held accountable. But at the same time, and the reason we focus on this, is don't tamper with these resources because they are meant to take us to 2050. They are meant to take us to somewhere else. And if you derail that program, if you take away these resources, you are derailing this program. So you just can't do that.